Jesteśmy w czytelni imienia Franciszka Pika Mirandoli, a w bibliotece Państwowej Wyższej Szkoły Zawodowej imienia Stanisława Pigonia w Krośnie. Rozmawiam z Vincenzo Alaterna, naszym studentem, który już jutro opuszcza Krosno. Przybył do nas z Włoch i na pewno zechce się z nami podzielić swoimi wrażeniami. Hello, Vincenzo.
Hello.
How did you find our school?
So, when I was in Milan, in Italy, my university, I had to do the Erasmus request, and I have found a lot of university, Russian and Polish university, and I have chosen this university because I know Poland, because I have been to Poland 4 years ago to Krakow for a travel, and I decided to go to Poland because I like this country.
You picked the translation studies in our college.
Yes.
How do you find it?
Very nice, very nice. Because I study Russian and English in my university, and I found the Russian courses very impressive. Because in my university we used to learn a lot of grammar, but here in Krosno I used to learn a lot of oral comprehension discourse. So it was very nice for improving my speaking, my Russian speaking, and also the English courses.
What does it mean to translate? What does it mean translation to you?
For me it's one of the most important thing in my life, because I love every type of languages. I already speak 5 languages: English, Italian, French, and Russian. And for me it's very important to speak a lot of languages, because if you want to find a job, to work, you have to speak minimum 2 languages: your native language and English. But if you speak other languages, you can find other opportunities.
How was the Erasmus program? How do you find it? What was the most exciting thing that you impressed here?
The most impressive thing was when I arrived to Krakow for the first time, because as I said, I have been to Krakow 1 time 4 years ago. So when I arrived to Krakow, it was like like a deja vu, and I loved this type of impression, but also I enjoyed my travel in Warsaw, in Rzeszów, in Sanok, in other part of Poland, and also in other countries like Germany, in Budapest. I was in Budapest, so I was in Czech Republic, so it was very interesting opportunity for my life. And I hope that a lot of students from Krosno will go to Italy or to other countries for doing an Erasmus program.
You traveled a lot, and I believe that you also met a lot of interesting new people.
Yeah, I met a lot of people, and I met a lot of Turkish people or Chinese people. They are no strange, but they are different from us, and it is very cool. It is a very cool thing, because you can talk about our differences, our different cultures, our different traditions, and it was very, very nice and very impressive. I love, for example, the Turkish guys and the Turkish culture. It was a very cool experience.
And as you understand, and we understand, most of the activities here and the things that you told us about are around intercultural communication.
Yeah.
Can you explain us what does it mean to you, intercultural communication?
So, I think that in our time, in 2019, if you want if you want to work, if you want to stay in this world, you have to be intercultural. I mean, you don't have to know every type of cultures. It's impossible, because you have to know Swahili, for example. It's impossible. But you have to learn by other people. For me, intercultural communication means that you have to know other cultures and other traditions. You have to learn by listening them, mm-hmm. you know. If you are able to be intercultural, you can live in this world, mm-hmm. I think that's. Mm-hmm.
You are studying in Poland right now. What are your plans for the future?
So, I have to take a degree in the next month, but maybe on September I will move to London for working, but I don't know, I have to decide, but maybe I will go to London, but or maybe I will go to Paris, because, you know, I like staying in a lot of part of the world, so I will change. Mm-hmm. So maybe on September we'll be in London, maybe on December I will be, I don't know, in Krakow, for example, again in Poland.
A może być, wy будете в Москве?
Да, в Москве, в Санкт-Петербурге.
Виченцо, переходя на русский, потому что вы говорите очень хорошо на русский, на русском языке. Если бы вы смогли порекомендовать программу Erasmus для наших студентов, может быть, для людей, которые приезжают к нам в Кросно, а может быть, тех, которые должны выехать из Кросно, например, в Италию, например, в Турцию и так далее.
Я думаю, что польские студентки должны идти в Erasmus программу, потому что это один из известных каникулих во всем мире, потому что если вы идете на Erasmus, например, в Италии, вы хотите искать много интересных ситуаций.
Впечатлений. Да. Угу. Спасибо вам большое.
Спасибо.
До встречи.
До свидания. До видения.
До свидания.